The Suns are looking to defeat their Western Conference rival going into this game. Well, before you look ahead to your busy week, sit down, relax, pull up a chair, as we bring you another NBA broadcast. And thanks for sharing part of your weekend with us. With Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and Hall of Fame sideline reporter David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. And tonight, we're joined by a legend of the NBA, five-time NBA champion, Kobe Bryant has stopped by. Kobe, great to have you with us.
No, thank you. Thank you for letting me stop in and join you for a bit.
Any chance you might pursue broadcasting in the years to come?
Nope.
Nor coaching?
Nope. Don't have the patience for either.
All right, we're glad you're with us tonight. Lakers are enjoying this break from the road. They've lost their last three games, and guys, they'd like that streak to end tonight here.
And it's in your DNA. You come up against a natural rival, you're going to be a little bit salty.
And that's what makes it fun. You love seeing these two teams go head-to-head. They're going all out.
We've got a chance here to set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for this one. On the court for the Suns, Booker and Bridges are the wings. Ayton is out there with T.J. Warren, and it's Melton in at the point guard. Kobe, when you think of that rough-and-tumble style of the Pistons and the Knicks in the 80s versus this more wide-open style, which style do you appreciate more, and which style was more difficult to play?
Well, personally, I always wanted to play in the 80s because of the defensive rules, the illegal defense rules, where you have to play man-to-man.
Yes.
You can't come in and 2-9 in the paint. There's no zone defenses.
Yeah.
You have to go mano-a-mano, right? If you're going to double-team.
You love that challenge.
Oh, my gosh. Come on now. People can't hide.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Players can't hide. You know, there's a player out there that might not be a good defensive player or doesn't really want to play defense. He can hide. In the 80s, you can't do that.
No hype.
No, there's no hype. You're on an island.
Here's James following the basket by T.J. Warren. Over Booker. LeBron can't get it to go.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that one.
Shoots over Ingram. That's short off the rim. Los Angeles has gone 1-2 from long range in the first quarter. And it's Rondo in the corner. LeBron against Bridges. Just four to shoot. And that one is good. James has got 5 points so far. And for those of us who have never played at this level, it must be a thrill to contend against the best in the world. Also with that comes a lot of pressure. How do you handle the balance between enjoying the game and the pressure that's on you in the game?
I've never felt pressure.
Hmm.
I'm not really sure what that is. I mean, you'll have moments where you'll make game-winning shots, and it's fantastic.
Never nervous.
No. At times where you'll miss it, and then people won't like you very much.
Mm-hmm.
But then the next game, you hit a game-winner, and everybody loves you. And then you miss the next one, and everybody don't like you again. Right? So why would I stress out over, quote-unquote, pressure? It doesn't make any sense to me.
How about the responsibility to your teammates and to your own built-in pressures to perform like Kobe Bryant?
Even that, right? Yeah. Even that. There'll be games where you make them, and your teammates are thanking you for it. At times when you miss it, and your teammates are like, dang, man, you got to do better, right? So it's ebbs and flows all the time. And internally, I just do what I practice.
Mm-hmm.
So there's no reason for me to be nervous or apprehensive because I've done this shot thousands and thousands and thousands of times. I just have to do it one more time.
And, Kobe, I know you'd spend a fair amount of time watching video and scouting your opponents. How would your film style change from regular season to say, the playoffs?
I had more time to prepare in the postseason so I can watch more film,
mm-hmm,
and really focus on the entire package of the team that we're facing.
Not just the guy that's defending you?
No, not just the guy that's defending me.
All of it.
But all of it.
Right.
Right? How do they play us defensively as a team? How do they play us individually? How do we need to play them as a team? How do we need to play them individually? Start looking at kind of the grand scheme of things. In a regular season, you know, most of these film sessions, for me at least anyway, took place on the plane.
Right.
Right, in between games.
Right.
So when I get to the hotel, I can rest generally.
Mm-hmm. Good! Crawford's got his first basket of the night. Lakers leading by three. Rondo kicks to LeBron. And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and two shots coming up.
And Rondo really more creative than given credit. Just has that knack for making defenders have to foul.
Lakers shooting their first free throws here for the night.
Take a break. Two shots.
And he makes the first.
And when engaged, Rondo is special. A triple-double threat who does a little bit of everything for his squad.
Michael Beasley, he's checked in for the Lakers. Caldwell Pope comes in for LeBron. Rashawn Holmes, he's checked in for the Suns. Oubre comes in for Booker. He's off on the second. Suns trail by four. To the paint. Inside, Warren. And it's Warren with the jam.
Well, T.J. Warren finishes with authority. We'll give you a salute, sir.
For the Phoenix Suns, they come into this one following a loss to the Nuggets in Denver.
Yeah, that was more than just a tough loss. That was a complete embarrassment.
Look, Greg, they simply didn't bring it. And that's one of those losses that you just have to throw away and forget about.
Here's Hart. Still looking for his first bucket in this one. Oubre pulls it in. Okobo. And he hits it to tie the game up.
How good is that pass? Certainly makes the offensive opportunity easy.
Pass to Caldwell Pope. No good on the three. The Suns have gotten 5 of 10 shots to drop in this game so far. Right at the 50% mark. Crawford against Caldwell Pope to the left wing. Okobo. No luck that time in the shot that would have put them on top. Tie game in Los Angeles. We've got more in store for you right after this. Well, you see a lot of players who pick up a controller and fire up NBA 2K, thank goodness, including the king himself, LeBron James.
And I play 2K all the time. Seriously, when I'm playing the game, I'm putting certain lineups on the court that I see could actually help us in real life, which is very weird.
Always experimenting, always keeping his mind engaged, Greg, with basketball.
And that's who Bron is. He lives, breathes, and eats basketball.
And getting going again here in the second quarter. Fairly close game so far. And taking a look at Los Angeles' performance here, what have they been doing or not doing?
You know, I like the confidence that they've shown here early on.
They're working together so well, and there's a level of certainty that comes from trusting one another.
Beasley is out there with Lance Stephenson, and there's JaVale McGee. Then it's Kentavious Caldwell-Pope, and it's Hart in at the one spot. That's the group for the Lakers to start the second quarter. First one falls for him. And the Black Mamba nickname, one of the things that I think fans really embrace. They know you for that. How did that all come about?
Well, watching Kill Bill.
Oh, no kidding.
No kidding. It came straight from Tarantino. When I saw him, I thanked him for it.
Oh, I like that story.
Yep, came straight from there. I looked at it and said, wow, that's an interesting animal.
Let me look it up. Makes sense.
Makes complete sense.
Right, yeah. And you like that? You like that nickname?
I did. It became my alter ego. Yeah. Right? So when I'm at home, I'm like a big teddy bear, man. I'm like a human jungle gym with my kids. But when I strap up my Mambas, I enter that zone. I enter that don't play around zone.
I like that zone. Yeah. Your opponents didn't like that zone. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Well, guys, Devin Booker is a 20-point-per-game scorer since his second season in the league, and he knows you have to have confidence to be a great shooter. He said, know the work you've put in, trust your game. Just because you miss shots, you can't doubt yourself. They're supposed to fall, and they will if you keep shooting. Kevin?
Next shot mentality for sure. Thanks, D.A. And the second free throw, good. Kobe, how important is it for young players to have mentors?
Extremely important. I consider them the North Star. Right? They're always there to provide guidance and kind of a map of generally where you want to go, or the direction you want to go. And I always felt muses were important because if I could study them and see how they got to where they are, it'll help me avoid some of the landmines that they may have stepped on and had to persevere through.
And gracious of you to become a mentor now for so many.
Well, it's part of the responsibility, I think, of giving back to the game, right? The game has given me so much. I've had great mentors in my life, and I feel like it's important to pay it forward.
Oh, just solid on the one-handed slam.
And guys, when it's a tight ball game like this, he's the guy they want with the ball. Now, here's Stevenson. And right now, he's averaging about 7 points a game.
And guys, right now, the defense mentally not there. Can't afford too many of those in a close game like this.
Yeah, Jay, you're right. Almost a free run for him there.
Yeah, with the score this tight, someone has to come over and take the charge or at least contest the shot.
And it's JaVale McGee with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. And some changes here for the Lakers. LeBron, he's checked in for Beasley. And it's Brandon Ingram in for Hart. And now approaching 2 minutes of action here in the second quarter. Here's Melton. He's guarded by Caldwell Pope. Melton, no good. The Lakers in the lead and playing in Los Angeles. Did you ever look into the crowd and just appreciate that platform and just think, wow, how can it get any better than Los Angeles and winning in Los Angeles?
Yeah. I mean, right? I used to look on the sidelines when I first came out here. You see Jack Nicholson. You see all of these A-list celebrities and actors. And the thing that I always found fascinating and interesting is that I would go and watch them on the screen. And here they're all watching me perform.
Yeah.
And it's fascinating. Because when we watch them on the screen performing, you understand that there's one take, there's two takes, there's three takes, right? There's prep that goes in. They're watching us perform. There are no backsies. Right, if I take a horrible shot, I can't say cut, take two. you know what I mean?
Exactly.
And so I took a lot of pride in trying to give them the best performance I possibly can, live and direct.
Here's Holmes, following the basket by Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. Here's Ayton, hits the front of the rim and out. Los Angeles leading by 6. Their offense has been great here.
Yeah, the ball movement has been terrific, and they've kept the defense off balance.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Melton passes to Holmes. Ayton dishes to Jackson. Just 5 on the clock. They need this. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. They host the 76ers after this game. That will complete this 4-game homestand. Ingram kicks to James. A chance to extend the lead to double digits, but it's no good. Well, Kobe, I know you can't stay any longer, but I just want to say thank you on behalf of all of our fans watching and playing the game tonight. Always a pleasure to have you drop by our broadcast.
No, thank you for having me, man. And anytime.
There he is, the legendary Kobe Bryant. And with Kobe stopping by the booth, Doris, I'm always amazed at the type of things Kobe will notice about both NBA and the players competing that the casual fans rarely think about.
Well, you think back to Kobe's career and how much his preparation and studying of the league and his opponents contributed to his success. And obviously, with what we just heard, this guy still holds so much knowledge of the game.
And first time out of the game called for Phoenix.
Yeah, it looked like they tried to shoot their way out of the slump, and that didn't work. They got to go back and regroup.
Yeah, maybe a new approach, because what they're doing is not working. You're going to have to alter some things on the offensive end.
And Los Angeles with some changes. Zubac is checked in for JaVale McGee. Kyle Kuzma comes in for Lance Stevenson. Rajon Rondo subbed in for Caldwell Pope. Drills the three-pointer. Booker's got himself on the board with 3 there.
Listen, there's no doubt this young man is one of the great young shooters from distance. Go ahead, Devin Booker, with that picture-perfect motion.
Now here's Rondo. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against Minnesota.
You know, he was also one of their key contributors on the glass. His effort was terrific.
And now you see them starting to really work the ball inside.
And Ayton throws it down.
You know, for a first guy early in his career, Booker's been tremendous finding the open man.
Booker against Rondo. Pass to LeBron. And it's good, coming on the assist by Rajon Rondo. Rondo's got his 4th assist in this one. That shot off. And so it's the Los Angeles Lakers going into the break with a 10-point lead. And they've done a phenomenal job down low. So many of their points coming right at the rim. And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Kentavious, you've been able to produce easily and efficiently in the first half. What's enabled you to keep it going?
I'm just moving on the offensive end and I just find an open spot. They turn their heads a lot, so I'm just trying to get to the open spot and then knock down a shot. Either I'm cutting to the back or spot up for the three.
You've been on a roll so far. We'll see if you can keep it up. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David, for that interview, and we'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball. The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
And what a show being put on here for the home fans tonight. I'm Ernie Johnson, along with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. LeBron James putting in some incredible work. He had 13 points, 3 rebounds, and 1 assist. After a subpar performance in their previous contest, he has come on strong tonight. His first half, sensational. And taking a look at the Lakers, Shaq, what'd you think?
Well, they're getting high percentage looks, good game planning. The ball is moving around. Guys aren't pulling the trigger at the first thing they see. They are definitely staying disciplined. That's a big part of what has them having the lead at the halftime.
Kenny, your take on Phoenix.
Well, they're giving up too many high percentage looks, Ernie. They're not closing down the lane, and they're not going hard on the perimeter. That will get an L in any book.
And that's going to do it for our halftime show, sadly. Third quarter about to start. See you again after the final
horn. Oh, buzzer.
And happy you could join us. We've got two quarters left to go in regulation. It's been a clinic out there by James.
I mean, he was prolific in that first half. You know it's coming, but it's just so tough to stop.
And this is what he does, right, Greg? He's out there to score the basketball, and throughout that first half, he dominated.
And we hope you've enjoyed the broadcast so far. We're halfway through the game. We've talked about what it takes to be a great head coach, Doris. Qualities that you think are paramount to the success, for instance, of an assistant coach.
Maybe the most important attribute to an assistant coach would be coaching with your heart and soul like it's your job on the line every night, not just the head coach's job. Mm. Right? If you pour your heart and soul into something and make that head coach's job easier, then you've functioned appropriately. And the other thing it's allowed you to do is it's allowed you to accelerate your growth. You're constantly thinking, what would I do in this situation? That helps you in the long term.
Love that perspective. Second half underway. Here's who Igor Kokoshkov's got on the floor. Booker and Bridges are the wings. Warren is out there with Ayton. And it's Melton in at the point. Now here's Booker. He's got 5 to the left side wing. And he's good on the 3-ball. Melton's got it back down to a single-digit deficit for the Suns. The Lakers shooting 65%, an outstanding offensive display from them. The wide-open look here for Kuzma, trying to answer back, but that three is off the mark. Ingram against Booker. Rondo looking around. Booker against Ingram. No good with the layup.
Boy, what a cold start to the second half for them. Just 1-for-4 from the field so far.
Ayton, and he floats in for the easy 2. Credit the assist on that one.
They wanted a fast start coming out of the break, and they are now 3-for-3.
Rondo kicks to LeBron. Shoots over Bridges. Offensive struggles continue, missing again.
Not how they hope to start the second half, missing 4 of their first 5 here.
Rondo with the ball. Taking a look at the scoring numbers. Right now he averages about 9 points a game. Ingram passes to Chandler. It's a nice passing here by Los Angeles. And the Lakers with another miss. Suns trail by 5.
Now remember, T.J. Warren, he averaged 25 a game his second season at NC State. You want to know his role in the NBA? It's quite simple. A professional scorer.
Here's LeBron after Mikal Bridges' bucket. Basket good. And that's 15 points for LeBron.
Yeah, not a lot to be done if LeBron gets a solid screen in a pick-and-roll set like that one.
And the Suns call time here. The Lakers with LeBron wasted no time trying to surround him with free agent signings, Greg, to help round out the supporting cast.
Names came in rapid succession after LeBron committed. Caldwell Pope, Rondo, Stevenson all joined in short order. We'll see how far this team goes, but you cannot deny how interesting things have gotten with this roster.
Catching up on the changes for Los Angeles, Zubats is checked in for Chandler. Beasley comes in for James. And it's Josh Hart in for Brandon Ingram. And this is what the schedule looks like coming up for the Phoenix Suns. On Tuesday, they'll be matching up against DeMar DeRozan and the San Antonio Spurs. And then on Saturday, the Atlanta Hawks come into town. That will tip off a homestand for them.
And for the matchup with the Jazz, they'll need to be at their best for this contest. Anything short of excellence, and they'll be in for a rough ride.
The first one falls. The Suns front office have said it's time to raise the bar. Doris, the rebuild can go on only so long. They don't want a losing mentality to set in.
Well, we've heard this before, Kevin, right? The open letter to fans in 2016 promising to turn it around. But in the end, it's not about words. It's about wins.
And both free throws good for Oubre.
Well, the Phoenix Suns guys have missed the playoffs for 8 straight seasons. That continues the longest playoff drought in franchise history.
Now here's Caldwell Pope. He has 5. To the inside. And he uses the glass on the layup. Caldwell Pope's got his 3rd basket of the night.
Yeah, and knifing into the middle. Caldwell Pope, not just a perimeter threat. Young fella can elevate.
And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. And before this drought, the Suns had missed the playoffs in consecutive seasons since the 1980s.
Well, remember, this was a very proud franchise, historically one of the league's best regular season records. Fans are so hoping they can get back on a winning track.
Shooting 2.
First one falls for him. Josh Jackson's checked in for Warren. And that one goes in. 2 from the line that time. The Suns coach Igor Kokoshkov has coached Slovenia to the 2017 Eurobasket title. Doris, the country's first ever European title. It certainly helped put his name on the map.
Yeah, no doubt, Kevin. This young man has had great success internationally and as an NBA assistant. And how about Kokoshkov, a homecoming in Phoenix? He and his family have maintained a house there for over a decade.
Crawford looking over the floor. The pass to Holmes. In the corner, it's Crawford. The Suns need to get a shot off. Holmes, good.
And not everyone can shoot this well at his size.
Yeah, there's no question about it. Guys with size don't necessarily translate into great shooters, but boy, does he show great confidence knocking that down.
The Lakers with the ball, following the score by Phoenix. Caldwell Pope kicks to Hart to the inside. And that one is good by Beasley. Beasley's got 4 points in the quarter.
Yeah, these defenders just look a bit overmatched, especially inside.
And here's Crawford. From deep. And he was able to put it up in time, but doesn't fall. And we've reached the end of the 3rd. Lakers lead by 5. And time for the short break, and stay right where you are. The 4th quarter is coming up next. Luke Walton had some advice for his team. Let's hear what he had to say.
Hey, great work. We're pushing the pace, we're making the extra pass, and we're being patient. Beautiful on offense.
Giving credit to his guys, Luke appreciates how they're working on offense.
I mean, they are humming along right now, and he has got to love it as a coach.
And I know I speak for all of us when I say I can't wait to see what kind of finish awaits us here in the fourth quarter. They've got Ivica Zubac. And Stevenson is out there with Kyle Kuzma. Then it's Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. And it's Hart in at the shooting guard position. That's the Laker five. Crawford outside. Down low, Okobo. Kuzma pulls it in.
Boy, that's exactly how you have to play defense when he's driving the lane. You cannot give him any space.
Really, really good possession there. They've never lost their focus, even as the game's gotten tight.
You know, a few more possessions like that one, and they can put the finishing touches on this game. They just have to have effective trips like that one.
And the Suns call time here. And what a draft day steal for the Lakers, who were able to get Kyle Kuzma, who had been drafted 27th overall.
Yeah, Kuzma came into the league far more polished than anyone expected, and you have to credit the young man's hard work and how he's able to make such a big splash that rookie year. And with how hard he works, Kuzma is going to be an impactful player in this league for a long time.
Some changes for the Lakers. Tyson Chandler, he's checked in for Zubac. LeBron comes in for Lance Stevenson. Rajon Rondo is subbed in for Kentavious Caldwell-Pope. And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
And guys, over that last break, I listened to Igor Kokoschkov address the team. He knows his team is struggling tonight from the three-point line, so he told them to go for more quality shots inside. We're shooting way too many threes, he said. No more Hail Marys. Let's get inside to the post. Back to you guys.
All right, thank you, David. And he comes up with the deuce.
Well, I'll tell you, it takes a lot of confidence to go with the floater. That is not as easy as it looks.
Enzo Crawford will bring it up for Phoenix. They trail by 9 points. Pass to Ayton. On the wing, Jamal Crawford. Booker outside. He kicks it to Warren. Fires the three. Good. A nice assist from Booker. Booker's got his third assist on the night.
Wow, if TJ Warren makes threes with consistency, it will unlock every other aspect of his game, and that's significant, guys.
Now here's LeBron, and the call on the shot that sends him to the line. That free throw, no good.
You have to love the leadership of LeBron James. Is he demanding of his teammates? Absolutely. But they can take it because he demands more from himself.
Bridges, he's checked in for the Suns. And he sinks the second. Suns trail by 7. Here's Booker. Makes it off the glass. Booker's got 4 points in the quarter.
You love it when guys play bigger than you think they are. Booker proving that he's not just a threat from the outside.
Now here's James. Pass to Kuzma. Outside Rondo. Clock at 4. Los Angeles needs to get off a shot here. And he gets contact and the whistle on the shot. Two shots coming up. And Phoenix gets called for the foul. And the first one at the line is good. And that's good as he hits both of his shots. A little over 2.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth quarter. Out to the wing. Here's Melton. He's covered by Rondo. Bridges misses.
All the time in the world to get that one off.
Here's Kuzma. And it's good coming on the assist by Rajon Rondo. Rondo's got his fifth assist in this one. Booker looking around. Outside Warren. Shoots over Kuzma. And the shot by Warren, no good. Lakers leading by 9. Inside, Rondo. It's blocked.
Tremendous at anticipating when shots are going up. Ayton is outstanding at protecting the rim.
Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Feeds to LeBron. Over Booker. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim. Suns trail by 9. This one for 3. And the 3-ball is good. Booker's got 9 points now in just the second half.
Yeah, one of his many attributes, guys. Booker is hard to stay with when he's pulling up off the dribble.
LeBron can't get it to go. Phoenix has gotten off 4 3-pointers in the final quarter, and 2 of them have fallen. And Booker kicks to Warren. Here's Ayton. He can't hit that time. Chandler with the defensive effort. Here's Hart. Rondo finds James. Shoots over Bridges. Another miss by James. And here are the Suns now. 6-point game. Bridges against James. To the wing on the left. Here's Ayton. It's in! And now they trail by just 4.
He is a great kid. I love to see this from Ayton, stepping up in the big moment, letting his talent take over. Honestly, just doing what they have to in order to get the basketball back.
And now we've got the intentional foul. Gets the first, and that puts them up by 5. And so he drops them both. It's a 6-point ball game.
Boy, very productive trip to the line that time, and they're sitting on a nice lead now.
Phoenix calls timeout. They're down by 6. 16 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
And I'm not sure the 2-point bucket does much here. I think they got to go for 3.
Unless it's an end one, a 2-pointer makes no sense. Unfortunately for them, the defense knows this too.
And now let's present our Jordan player of the game, LeBron James.
And I love that it's been a hard charging performance. Jump shots have been kind of an afterthought. His main goal has been to attack the rim and put the D in some tough spots, and also finishing strong.
Warren on the wing. Fires for 3. It's hauled in by LeBron. And he commits the intentional foul. Gets the first, and that makes it a 7-point lead. And he hits both free throws here. So now it's an 8-point game. And the Suns call time here. They're behind by 8. 6 seconds left to play here in the fourth. What's your take, guys?
And obviously, look, they want to finish the game strong, but right now, look at the frustration on their faces.
It's very evident, Greg. You can tell they're upset. They've got to calm down and simply play this one possession at a time.
Kicks it to Jackson. Here's AC. A three-pointer off the mark. And so Los Angeles takes the win. Even early on in this one, it seemed like they were happy to be playing at home tonight.
And it makes a big difference. Once they started to really play in rhythm, you never felt like they had any doubts as to whether or not they were going to win.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. LeBron, were you satisfied with the team's performance tonight?
We got a very good team, but in order for us to continue to improve, we have to go out and we have to defend, we have to play for one another, and we have to be selfless. You know, it's not about the individual, it's about the team, and if we all give in to what the team needs to do to be better, then we'll be okay.
It is a work in progress, LeBron. Thanks for your time. Kevin?
David, thank you as always. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. So long and good night, everyone.